Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Now our today's topic is ascent of SAP or upward conduction of water. As you know that in our previous classes we talked about water absorption, passive absorption, active absorption, different pathways like apoplastic pathway, symplastic pathway. We talked about the different forms of soil water. Now, water had entered the plant from soil solution, from rhizosphere's soil solution. Water had entered the xylem element of the root, the vascular system of the root. But water has to reach from root system to the shoot system. This movement of water, this transport, upward transport of water from root system to the tip of stem, to the tip of leaves, is referred as ascent of sap. Now the question is, why sap? Actually, the water within the soil is not pure water. It is a solution. Water is nowhere pure. In a plant, there is no pure water. In an animal, there is no pure water. In soil, there is no pure water. It is a solution. Pure water exists only in chemist's lab. That is a laboratory condition. In nature, there is solution. Somewhere it is dilute, somewhere it is concentrated. What is there in soil solution? It is water plus dissolved soil water with dissolved ingredients is called a sap. The soil water with dissolved soil water with dissolved ingredients soil water with dissolved ingredients soil water with dissolved ingredients is called sap. So what is sap? It is water plus ingredients of the soil. That is water plus minerals. That is water plus minerals. प्लांट जमीन से साफ पानी नहीं लाता है. इट इज डर्टी वाटर. इट इज वाटर प्लस इंग्रेडिएंट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट नेचर. नॉट ओनली इनऑर्गेनिक मिनरल्स, सम ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल्स आर आल्सो अब्सॉर्ब्ड बाय द प्लांट फ्रॉम द सॉइल फ्रॉम अमीनो एसिड्स. बिफोर 1770, इट वॉज बींग बिलीव्ड दैट वट एवर ए प्लांट नीड्स फॉर इट इज सर्वाइवल, फॉर इट इज वेरी एग्जिस्टेंस, दैट होली एंड सोली कम्स फ्रॉम सॉइल. Then later on when the concept of photosynthesis was recognized, photosynthesis के बारे में जब knowledge हासिल हुई तब जाके पता चला नहीं atmosphere का role है, नहीं light का role है. पहले ये believe किया जाता था कि plants सब कुछ soil से लाते हैं roots के जरिए, इसीलिए plants को padappa कहते थे. Padappa in Sanskrit means organisms who are nourished through peat. अरे बच्चों को तो ये पता होगा क्योंकि मेरा statement है, अक्सर बेस्तर में क्लास में कहा करता था padappa, plants are padappa. Padappa means nourished through feet. Feet of the plant or its roots. And the nourishing medium was soil substratum. Soil was referred as bank of nutrients. Some botanists are of the opinion, they claim that no soil, no life. No soil, no life. Soil is the mother of plants. From this soil, plants absorb water. Not pure form. It is a solution. Plants are nature's best processors. They absorb dirt, they absorb water plus minerals with noxious smell and they convert it into palatable items which are in our breakfast and our lunches. See, plants absorb sap from the soil, then conduct it. The upward conduction of water plus minerals, the upward conduction movement of water from roots to tip of stem and leaves the upward conduction of water from roots to tip of stem and leaves is referred as ascent of sap. हम किसको ascent of sap कहते हैं? The upward movement of water from roots towards the tips of stem and leaves is referred as ascent of sap. Soil से root तक, root here to epidermis, epidermis to cortex, cortex to endodermis, endodermis to pericycle, then pericycle to xylem. It is absorption, either apoplastically or symplastically. After absorption, there is second step, that is conduction, that is translocation, that is from one system to another system within a plant. Now, it is not from soil to plant, it is from one organ of the plant to other organs. From root system to shoot system. Movement of water from root system to shoot system is unidirectional. The unidirectional movement of water from root system to shoot system is called upward conduction or ascent of sap. Hum simply likh sakte hain. The unidirectional movement of water. The unidirectional movement of water, the unidirectional movement of water, the unidirectional movement of water, unidirectional movement of water unidirectional movement of water from root system to shoot system. Unidirectional movement of water from root system to shoot system. Shoot system is called upward conduction of water. Upward conduction of water. Conduction of water
or ascent of SAP. Ascent of SAP. The unidirectional movement of water from root system to shoot system is called upward conduction of water or ascent of SAP. So our today's concern is, today's topic is how water is shifted from root system to shoot system. In previous classes, we were discussing how water will enter the soil. From soil solution to the plant root. From soil capillaries to the plant root to xylem. Now, from plant root to xylem, after the plant root to xylem to stem xylem, to leaf xylem, from root tip to shoot tip, from root system to shoot system, this movement of water, this transport, unidirectional transport of water is referred as ascent of sap. Ascent of sap occurs through ascent of sap in vascular plants ascent of sap in vascular plants, that is tracheophytes, occurs through trachery elements of xylem. The ascent of sap, that is upward conduction of water plus minerals, in vascular plants occurs through, vascular plants are also called tracheophytes. Yeah, vasculars to be appropriate. Tracheophytes occurs through trachery elements. Ascent of sap occurs through trachery elements of xylem. कहां से ascent of sap होता है? Vascular plants. Ascent of sap in vascular plants occurs through trachery elements. अब आपको कह सकते trachery elements क्या होते हैं? देखिए, जिन प्लांट्स में वेस्कुलर सिस्टम होता है वही हम कंडक्शन की बात करते हैं, वही हम कंडक्टिंग सिस्टम का नाम लेते हैं. देखिए, प्लांट्स, लोअर प्लांट्स जो है, जिनको हम क्रिप्टोगैम्स कहते हैं, जिनको हम सेलुलर्स कहते हैं, या नॉन वेस्कुलर प्लांट्स या ट्रैकियोफाइट्स कहते हैं, जिनमें एल्गी है, जिनमें ब्रायोफाइट्स है, वहां एक कंडक्टिंग सिस्टम नहीं है, वो नॉन वेस्कुलर है. वहां जनरल बॉडी के जरिए, डिफ्यूजन के जरिए ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ मटेरियल्स होता है थ्रू आउट द बॉडी. लेकिन जब हम बात करते हैं हायर प्लांट्स की, टेरिडोफाइटा की, जिम्नास्पर्म्स की, एंजियोस्पर्म्स की, टेरिडोफाइटा, जिम्नास्पर्म्स एंड एंजियोस्पर्म्स आर वेस्कुलर प्लांट्स, दे आर ट्रैकियोफाइट्स, दे आर ट्रू प्लांट्स, दे हैव कंडक्टिंग सिस्टम. And in conducting system, there are two types of vascular tissue. There are two types of conducting tissues. There is xylem, there is phloem. Xylem for conduction of water and minerals, and phloem for transport of food. Since hum baat karte hai water ki, lehaza xylem ka hi naam lenge. Ascent of sap in vascular plants occurs, that is tracheophytes. Tracheophyte ka mein aayega, pteridophyta, gymnosperm or endosperm. Occurs through trachery elements. ट्रैकरी एलिमेंट सबसाइलम, दैट इज वेसल्स एंड ट्रैकीड सबसाइलम, दैट इज वेसल्स एंड ट्रैकीड्स. Vessels and tracheids. Vessels and tracheid subxylem. Vessels and tracheids are conducting cells. These two conducting cells are collectively referred as trachery elements. So plant conducts water from root system to shoot system through xylem. Which part of the xylem? Trachery elements. What are trachery elements? These are vessels and tracheids. Xylem, word xylem had been derived from xylos. Xylos, according to Nagle, xylos means wood. Xylem is a complex tissue. A tissue whose constituting cells are different is referred as complex tissue. Xylem has different types of cells. Vessels, tracheids, parenchyma, fibers. But out of these cells, vessels and tracheids, dead cells, are responsible for upward conduction of water. Both vessels and tracheids are dead cells. Yad rakhiyega. Both vessels and tracheids are dead cells. Vessels and tracheids are. So dead cells of xylem are responsible for upward conduction of water. What is ascent of sap? Movement, unidirectional movement of water from root system to the shoot system is referred as ascent of sap or upward conduction of water. It occurs through vascular system. What is that vascular system? That is xylem in case of vascular plants. Xylem ke through water conduct hota hai unidirectionally from root to shoot upwards, upward conduction. Lekin xylem ki kin cells ke zariye? Vessels aur tracheids ke zariye. और वेसल्स और ट्रैकीड्स को हम कलेक्टिवली ट्रैकरी एलिमेंट्स कहते हैं. जो टेडोफाइटा और जिम्नास्पर्म्स है वहां ट्रैकीड्स के जरिए मैक्सिमम कंडक्शन होता है क्योंकि वहां वेसल्स नहीं है. एक्सेप्शनली किसी प्लांट में होगी लेकिन वो रूल नहीं बनेगा. रूल मेजोरिटी का बनता है. मेजोरिटी में वेसल्स एडवांस्ड कंडक्टिंग सेल्स है. वो एंजियोस्पर्म्स की प्रॉपर्टी है जो इस जमीन की सबसे एडवांस्ड प्लांट्स है. टेडोफाइटा और जिम्नास्पर्म्स में ट्रैकीड्स के जरिए कंडक्शन होता है लेकिन एंजियोस्पर्म्स में वेसल्स भी है ट्रैकीड्स भी. वाटर और सैप. वाटर और सैप is lifted from tips of roots water or sap is lifted from tips of roots to the shoot tips. Against the force of gravity. Against the force of water or sap is lifted from tips of roots to the shoot tips. That is leaf tips, stem tips, branch tips. Against the force of gravity. Up to a height of more than 100 meters. height of more than 100 meters in case of tall trees. क्योंकि सभी प्लांट सर्वेशियस नहीं है, सभी प्लांट श्रब्स नहीं है. देर आर रिकॉर्ड क्रिएटर्स अमंग जिम्नास्पर्म्स एंड अमंग एंजियोस्पर्म्स. एंजियोस्पर्म्स हैव टॉलेस्ट ट्रीज, जिम्नास्पर्म्स हैव टॉलेस्ट ट्रीज. ट्रीज की हाइट 100 मीटर से ऊपर जाती है. लिहाजा प्लांट हमें सिर्फ हर्बेशियस प्लांट्स की बात नहीं करनी है, हमें सिर्फ श्रब्स की बात, मैं जनरल में बात करता हूं. वहां प्लांट 100 मीटर से भी ऊपर की हाइट रखते हैं. दे आर हैविंग हाइट मोर देन 100 मीटर्स. सो व्हेन वी से एसेंट ऑफ सैप, इट इज मूवमेंट ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम रूट सिस्टम अपवर्ड्स टू द टिप ऑफ द शूट सिस्टम अगेंस्ट द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी. इन केस ऑफ टॉल ट्रीज वाटर इज टू बी कंडक्टेड अपवर्ड्स अगेंस्ट द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी. 100 मीटर से ज्यादा जाएगा वाटर. द रेट ऑफ मूवमेंट इन एसेंट ऑफ सैप the rate of movement is 25 to 75 25 to 75 centimeters per minute. Rate of movement or the speed of movement is 25 to 75 centimeters per minute. Now the question is, what force is the driving force by virtue of which water is conducted upwards, not dragged downwards? Or we have to recognize, we have to identify that force in a plant by virtue of which it is able to disregard the effect of gravity. Gravity drags materials downwards, but against the force of gravity, water is being conducted upwards. हमें घर में 10 फुट से 20 फुट से पानी ऊपर लाना होता है, हमें वहां मोटर एडजस्ट करने पर, विच मोटर इज एक्चुअली वर्किंग अगेंस्ट ग्रेविटी सो दैट प्लांट्स कंडक्ट वाटर अपवर्ड्स. और इन अदर वर्ड्स, व्हाट इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एसेंट ऑफ सैप, व्हाट अंडरलाइंग कॉज, व्हाट अंडरलाइंग फोर्स पुल्स और पुशेस द वाटर अपवर्ड्स. We have to understand that. That is the mechanism. Different theories have been proposed to explain the mechanism of ascent of sap. Different theories have been put forward in order to explain the mechanism for upward conduction of water and minerals. हाँ, हमने माना कि प्लांट ग्रेटर हाइट्स लेते हैं. कोई हर्ब है, कोई अंडर श्रब है, कोई अंडर श्रब है, कोई ट्री है. लेकिन जब उसके रूट से शूट सिस्टम तक वाटर जाता है, मिनरल्स जाते हैं यूनिडायरेक्शनली अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन में, उसके लिए ड्राइविंग फोर्स कौन है? ग्रेविटी के अगेंस्ट कौन सा फोर्स काम करता है जो पानी को ऊपर ले जाता है? पानी नीचे से पुश होता है या ऊपर से पुल होता है? उसमें प्लांट का क्या रोल है या पानी का अपना क्या रोल है? दैट विल एक्सप्लेन अस व्हाट इज द मैकेनिज्म फॉर अपवर्ड कंडक्शन ऑफ वाटर. सो वी मस्ट नो द केमिस्ट्री ऑफ वाटर, वी मस्ट नो द एनाटॉमी ऑफ प्लांट, एंड वी मस्ट नो द इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्रेविटी, वी मस्ट नो द कैपिलरी एक्शन, वी मस्ट नो द अदर मेटाबॉलिक पैरामीटर्स इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द अपवर्ड कंडक्शन ऑफ वाटर. सो इट्स अ फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस, मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज वाटर कंडक्टेड डजंट मीन वाटर पर से. प्लांट इज नॉट कंडक्टिंग वाटर ओनली वाटर, दिस कंडक्टिंग चैनल, दिस हाईवे विद इन द प्लांट विच कंडक्ट्स वाटर अफर्स, दिस चैनल इज ऑल्सो कंडक्टिंग केमिकल्स, मिनरल्स. प्लांट लूज 98% ऑफ द एब्जॉर्बड एंड कंडक्टेड वाटर. दे लूज ओनली वाटर, नॉट मिनरल्स. Plants absorb more, plants conduct more, they lose more, but they get nutrients. So when they absorb and conduct more, then and only then they get more nutrients. More absorption and more conduction also helps in transport of minerals. Plants have no heart, plants have no kidneys. What these organisms are performing, that is being performed by water. So water has more relevance with plants than with animals. That is why we say plant-water relations. Many functions are performed by water in plants, which in animals have different, in case of animals there are different systems to operate such functions. Plants can conduct water more than 100 meters of height. This is uniqueness. How this water is conducted upwards? What is the driving force for this upward conduction of water? For that matter, different theories have been proposed. Different theories have been put forward in order to explain the mechanism of upward conduction of water. Upward conduction of water and minerals. Because water alone is not absorbed. It is water plus minerals, what is called SAP. That is why we refer it as ascent of SAP. Hum usko kya likhte hain? Ascent of SAP. Ascent of SAP. Or upward conduction of SAP. Upward conduction of water plus minerals. Water plus inorganic ingredients. Ascent of SAP के लिए जो theories दी गई है उनमें से तीन main theories है. Three main theories three main theories have been proposed in order to explain the mechanism of upward conduction of water. These theories are include number one, vital forest theories. Number two, root pressure theory. Root pressure theory. नंबर थ्री पल्सेशन थ्योरी, पल्सेशन थ्योरी। रूट प्रेशर थ्योरी, वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी, रूट प्रेशर थ्योरी एंड फिजिकल फोर्स थ्योरी। फिजिकल फोर्स थ्योरी थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ थ्योरीज हैव बीन प्रपोज्ड बाय डिफरेंट वर्कर्स प्लांट फिजियोलॉजिस्ट्स इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सप्लेन द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एसेंट ऑफ सैप, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ अपवर्ड कंडक्शन ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम रूट जाइलम टू सिटम जाइलम, फ्रॉम रूट जाइलम टू लीफ जाइलम, फ्रॉम रूट टू शूट। What is the driving force for upward conduction, unidirectional upward conduction of water and minerals? That is called ascent of sap. And the mechanism for this ascent of sap has been differently explained by different workers, by different plant physiologists. Generally, three theories are there. First, vital force theory. Second, root pressure theory. Third, physical force theory. Vital force theories. 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 Vital force theories state that the metabolic activity of living cells of plant root, metabolic activities of living cells of plant root are responsible for ascent of sap. According to vital force theories, according to vital force theories, vital force theories, according to vital force theories, the living, the metabolic activity of metabolic activities of metabolic activities of living cells of plant roots metabolic activities of living cells of plant roots are responsible for upward conduction of water. Now the force is just developed. It develops due to metabolic activity. They claim that living cells are responsible. Metabolic activities of the living cells are developing a force which pushes the water upwards. The metabolic activities of living cells, vital force theory stated that metabolic एक्टिविटीज ऑफ लिविंग सेल्स ऑफ प्लांट रूट्स डेवलप a vital force, develop a vital force which pushes the water upwards, which pushes the water upwards.
यानी जैसे अगर आप केमिस्ट्री पढ़ते हो, केमिस्ट्री में वो ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री में आपको पढ़ाता है वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी. अकॉर्डिंग टू वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी इन केमिस्ट्री इट वाज बीइंग बिलीव्ड दैट ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स कम फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स ओनली बिकॉज दे हैव अ वाइटल फोर्स बाय वर्चू ऑफ इट दे आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. नो डाउट दैट थ्योरी हैड बीन डिस्कवर्ड इन केमिस्ट्री. सिमिलरली अ थ्योरी कॉल्ड एज वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी फॉर अपवर्ड कंडक्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड मिनरल्स stated that when metabolic activities of living cells occur, when metabolically active living cells function, they develop a force which pushes the water upwards. In an upward movement of water occurs due to metabolism. Metabolism cannot be shown by dead cells, it is shown by living cells. So they blame that living cells, metabolic activities of living cells, the plant roots, are responsible for upward conduction of water. But these theories nowadays have lost their significance. They are only historically important. They are only academically important. Aaj in theories ko accepted nahi kiya jata. Different reputed plant physiologists have proposed these vital force things. But with the passage of time, with the more advancement in plant physiology, with the more advancement in cell biology, with the more advancement in biochemistry, it had been confirmed that these theories are no more a driving force. They do not explain the force underlying for upward conduction of water. These theories have been discarded. I will discuss why. As they cannot explain, before talking about why they have been discarded, what is the criticism against these theories, you must remember just names of some theories, some important vital force theory. Just remember their names. No doubt they are not significant at present because they have lost their significance. They are not acceptable as they are not correct theories. Some important, academically they are important. You may be asked question like, what are vital forces or why they have been discarded? Some important vital force theories include some important vital force theories include number one, relay pump theory. Wester Mears, Wester Mears theory. इसी तरह से pulsation theory. ये वेस्टरमेयर की थ्योरी है, ये गॉडलीविस्की की थ्योरी है, ये जेसी बोस की थ्योरी है. लेकिन इन सभी थ्योरीज का एक कॉमन पॉइंट है, एक कॉमन स्टेटमेंट है, इनका एक जनरल बिलीफ है कि जो
प्लांट के रूट की लिविंग सेल्स है, उनकी मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी से जो फोर्स डेवलप होता है वही वाटर को अब फोर्स पुश करता है. ऑल वाटर फोर्स थ्योरीज हैव वन थिंग कॉमन, दैट इज द बिलीव दैट द मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटीज ऑफ लिविंग सेल्स ऑफ द प्लांट रूट्स आर creating or generating or developing a pulsation or developing a porous which pushes the water upwards. But in actual sense, in real practice, the force developed due to metabolic activity of roots, that is vital force. Vital force is not sufficient to push the water in case of tall trees. Vital force theories have been discussed. Vital force theories have been discarded. As number one, they fail to explain the force responsible for, they fail to explain the driving force, they fail to explain the driving force responsible for upward conduction of water. They fail to explain the driving force responsible for upward conduction of water. Let us suppose that driving force is metabolic force. The magnitude of metabolic force is insufficient to push the water in case of tall trees, as vital force is not sufficient to push the water in case of tall trees. Because these theories believe vital force is metabolic force, or I may say living force, as vital force is not sufficient. Vital force is not sufficient enough to push the water. Vital force is not sufficient enough to push the water upwards in case of tall trees. हाँ, अगर मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी से फोर्स डेवलप होता है, लेकिन वो फोर्स इस मैग्नीट्यूड का नहीं है कि टॉल ट्रीज जहां 100 मीटर से भी ज्यादा हाइट है वहां तक के लिए वो फोर्स सफिशिएंटली वाटर को ले जाएगा. वाटर वहां इस फोर्स से नहीं पहुंच पाएगा. दिस वन विजिबल ऑब्जेक्शन टू वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी. सेकेंड, सी, vital force or living force is a metabolic force developed in the roots of the plants. Strasburger, a renowned plant physiologist, in 1891, date ka khayal rakhiyega kyunki dates ka jo subject hai wo history hai, dates pe aap khud bhi dekh sakte ho. Strasburger in 1891 proved that plants can conduct water even when their roots are cut. Strasburger in 1891 removed the roots of plants under laboratory conditions, and those plants were able to conduct water normally. Since vital force or metabolic force or living force which develops in the roots is no more than roots are cut, If driving force is vital force, then there should be no ascent of sap when the roots are cut. But plants conducted water normally, even when their roots were removed. Thus criticizing, thus objecting, thus discarding vital force theory. Beyond limits, हम कह सकते हैं beyond doubts हम कह सकते हैं कि vital force theory driving force नहीं है, क्योंकि vital force theory हमें ये कहती है कि root की metabolic, root की living cells की metabolic activity से एक force बनता है जो पानी को ऊपर लेता है. जब हमने root cut किए तो वो force नहीं बना, तब जाके conduction नहीं होना चाहिए था, लेकिन conduction होता है. Strasburger in 1891 confirmed that plants can conduct water normally even when their roots are removed or cut. जब एक प्लांट रूट रिमूव होने के बावजूद भी वाटर कंडक्ट कर सकता है, इसका मतलब है वहां कोई वाटर फोर्स ऑपरेट नहीं होता है, क्योंकि जो वाटर फोर्स रूट में ऑपरेट होता है वो तब जाके खत्म हो जब रूट कट किया. नॉट ओनली दिस, व्हेन रूट सेल्स वर ट्रीटेड विद हीट देयर मेटाबॉलिज्म गेट्स अरेस्टेड, देयर मेटाबॉलिज्म इज स्विच्ड ऑफ व्हेन दे आर हीट ट्रीटेड, और व्हेन दे आर ट्रीटेड विद मेटाबॉलिक पॉइजंस देयर शुड बी नो वाटर फोर्स. रूट रिमूव नहीं किया. When root cells are killed, either by heat treatment or by treating them with metabolic poisons like carbolic acid, like picric acid, they kill the cell. They arrest its metabolism. Then there should be no, when there is no metabolic activity, if metabolic activity creates a vital force, at that time there is no vital force when metabolic activity has been killed, has been switched off by heat treatment. Then there should be no conduction, but conduction was normal. Conduction of water water or ascent of sap conduction of water or ascent of sap was normal when living cells of roots were treated with heat, were given heat treatment. Living cells of roots were treated with heat or killed with metabolic poisons. Like picric acid, or carbolic acid. देखिए मैंने आपको बता दिया कि जो वाइटल फोरस थेरीज है ये हमें ये बताती है कि जो लिविंग सेल्स प्लांट के रूट्स की जो लिविंग सेल्स है उनकी मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी से लिविंग सेल्स की मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी से एक फोर्स डेवलप होता है, उस फोर्स को जो लिविंग फोर्स कहलाता है वाइटल फोर्स कहते हैं, और यही वाइटल फोर्स ड्राइविंग फोर्स है फॉर पुशिंग द वाटर अपवर्ड्स। दिस इज वाइटल फोर्स है, चाहे वो रिले पंप थ्योरी हो, चाहे वो पल्सेशन थ्योरी हो, चाहे वो वेस्टर्न मेयर्स थ्योरी हो, सभी थ्योरीज का यही एक अंडरलाइंग फंडा है कि ड्राइविंग फोर्स लिविंग फोर्स है और वाटर पुश होता है अपवर्ड्स। मान लिया हमने वाइटल फोर्स है, लेकिन वाइटल फोर्स का मैग्नीट्यूड उतना नहीं है जिससे टॉल ट्रीज तक पानी पहुंचेगा, नंबर फर्स्ट। नंबर सेकंड, दिस वाइटल फोर्स इज ड्यू टू मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी ऑफ रूट्स। When Strasburger removed the roots, when Strasburger cut the roots of the plant, at that time there is no vital force, then there should be no conduction. But he was surprised that their conduction was normal as usual. Number three, when we treat the living cells of the root with heat, when we treat the living cells of the root with metabolic poisons like picric acid, like carbolic acid, at that time metabolism is arrested. There should be no ascent of sap, but ascent of sap was normal. Thereby confirming beyond doubts that vital force theories are only academically important, they are only historically important, but they have lost their significance, they are not at present acceptable. What is root pressure theory? How root pressure will explain us the mechanism of upward conduction of water? That I will discuss in next class. Assalamu alaikum.